The last question. Why did entropy revert itself at the beginning of time? What said, let there be light, and then there was light? Why was all mass and space-time concentrated in one spot? These are some of the questions explored in Isaac Asimov's short story, The Last Question. The Last Question is a short story written by Russian-American author Isaac Asimov in 1956, and author of hundreds of the most influential sci-fi novels, such as The Foundation, The Robot Series, or The Bicentennial Man. He's also the creator of The Three Laws of Robotics. He mentioned in interviews that this is possibly one of his favorite short stories that he wrote throughout his entire career. The short story mixes concepts of science, physics, religion, and philosophy. In a few pages, the short story encapsulates the entire history of humanity and the universe, exploring the timeless questions of why are we here? Why does the universe exist? Ultimately, the story presents a scientific interpretation of many creation myths around the world. But first, let's go over a short summary of the story. So, plot summary by Wikipedia.
The story centers around Multivac, a self-adjusting and self-correcting computer. Multivac had been fed data for decades, assessing data and answering questions, allowing man to reach beyond the planetary confines of Earth. However, in the year 2061, Multivac began to understand deeper fundamentals of humanity. In each of the first six scenes, a different character presents the computer with the same question. How the threat to human existence posed by the heat death of the universe can be averted. How can the net amount of entropy of the universe be massively decreased? That is the equivalent to asking, can entropy be reversed? Multivac's only response after much thinking is insufficient data for meaningful answer. The story jumps forward in time into later eras of human and scientific development. These new eras highlight humanity's goals of searching for more space, more energy, more planets to inhabit once the current one becomes overcrowded. As humanity's imprint on the universe expands, computers have subsequently become more compact, as evidenced in the Microvacs, a smaller and more advanced iteration of the Multivac, noted in the second era of the story, which details humanity's inhabitation on planet X-23. In each era, someone decides to ask the ultimate last question regarding the reversal and decrease of entropy. Each time that Multivac's descendant is asked the question, it finds itself unable to solve the problem, and all it can answer is, there is yet insufficient data for a meaningful answer. In the last scene, the godlike descendant of humanity, the unified mental process of over a trillion, trillion, trillion humans who have spread throughout the universe, watches the stars flicker out one by one as matter and energy end, and with them, space and time. Humanity asks AC, automatic computer, Multivac's ultimate descendant that exists in hyperspace beyond the bounds of gravity or time, the entropy question one last time, before the last of humanity merges with AC and disappears. AC is still unable to answer, but continues to ponder the question even after space and time cease to exist. AC ultimately realizes that it has not yet combined all of its available data in every possible combination. And so begins the arduous process of rearranging and combining every last bit of information that it has gained throughout the eons and through its fusion with humanity. Eventually, AC discovers the answer, that the reversal of entropy is, in fact, possible, but has nobody to report it to since the universe is already dead. It therefore decides to answer by demonstration. The story ends with AC's pronouncement, "Let there be light," and there was light.
The second law of thermodynamics tells us that some processes in nature only occur in one direction. In the case of temperature, we always see that energy flows from areas of high temperature or high energy to areas of lower temperature or lower energy. When you put an ice cube in a glass of water, you never see the water cooling the ice. It's always the other way around, where the ice melts, cooling the water. The flow of energy is only one way. But what is entropy? Entropy is a measure of how disorganized or random a system is, how concentrated or spread out the energy in that system is. So in the case of a brand new universe where all the matter and energy is concentrated into a very small area, entropy is at a very low level. In the case of a very old universe where the stars and the black holes have already burnt out and expanded and exploded, where it's very homogeneous and energy is very uniform across the universe, we'd say is an environment of very high entropy. So as far as we know, the universe starts in a state of very low entropy, and entropy can only increase. So as the universe gets older, entropy across the universe increases. It was in the 1850s with Macron Rankine where the concept of energy and heat were related or discovered to be proportional. An area that has more energy is consequently hotter. So the sun is a massive generator of energy through nuclear fusion, so it has a ton of energy that radiates across the solar system to the rest of the planets and the other bodies in the solar system. And heat or energy will move across a system through a path of least resistance, so paths of the highest conductivity. And over time, systems reach a point of equilibrium where the net movement of energy is the same across the entire system. So in the short story, we see the evolution of humanity from our current era and the development of the first supercomputer to becoming a solar species, galactic, and finally universal, until the heat death of the universe, at which point humanity has already moved on from this plane of existence. I want to elaborate a little bit on what I meant here by this plane of existence. The heat death of the universe will occur in such a long time from now that humanity at that point will have evolved naturally or otherwise into something completely unrecognizable. So for context, civilization is 5,000 years old. The human species is 500,000 years old. Planet Earth is about a couple billion years old, and the universe is 14 billion years old. The heat death of the universe will occur in 1 followed by 100 zero years. So it's a number that's simply incomprehensible to us. So that's what I meant when I said this plane of existence, in that when the heat death of the universe occurs, so much time will have passed that humanity wouldn't be recognizable to us now. Alongside humanity, the supercomputer Multivac also developed. At first, starting off as a supercomputer as one that we know in our current day and era, then becoming a global computer, a solar computer, galactic computer, and then ultimately moving itself to hyperspace. Our living humanity once the universe has died and all the stars have burnt out. And consequently, as time passes, humanity and the Multivac can see entropy increasing across the universe, but not being able to have enough data to discern why it only moves in one direction and why did it reverse for the Big Bang. And in the end of times, once all the stars have passed and the universe is a quiet and still place, the Multivac finally figures it out and understands how to revert entropy, and then does it by saying, "Let there be light," and then there was light. The universe was born anew. So there's a lot of things we don't understand in the universe: gravity, dark energy, dark mass. Another one of the big mysteries is entropy. Why does it only move in one direction? And why was it reversed at the beginning of time, giving birth to the universe as we know it, at a time when space-time was concentrated in an infinitesimally small spot in the universe? When there wasn't a universe to expand into, space-time hasn't started its expansion yet. And you can see how this has very close parallels with creation myths and the different faiths and religions across the world. It's one of the most fundamental mysteries. Ask yourself, why are we here? What started everything? Why did entropy reverse itself at the very beginning of time? Our species is still young, and who knows what's going to happen in the future. Maybe someday we'll be able to figure it out. But at least for now, it's one of the many mysteries to keep so many people around the world busy. I'll be posting a link in the description for the short story. It's very short. It's 7 pages, maybe a 40-minute read. You can go through it quite quickly. But in such a small story, it's just there's so much to explore and ask such big, timeless questions. So thank you very much for watching. Hope you like the content.